Okay, I think that we should watch this just for inspo, okay?
Okay. Oh, I... Yeah, right. Okay.
So I'm going to say it's Weekend Update, I'm Colin Jost, and you'll say that Michael Che?
Wait, no. I feel like I'm more Jost.
No, but you're not. Like, we asked the new scene class, and they voted that I was Colin Jost and you were Michael Che.
I swear if we took another poll, they would definitely...
No, because, like, I'm sitting on Colin's side, I swear. No, like, this is Colin, and you're Michael.
Totally not. No, you're on the left side. You're
this
on
is stupid. It's stupid.
5, 4, 3, 2...
I'm Sabine.
And I'm Lola.
Let's kick this episode off with a very special weekly What's on the Brain. This week, I was informed that I would be allowed to read my list of celebrity crushes for you all. So here you go. Dylan O'Brien, Timothy Chalamet, Tom Holland, Rudy Perry.
My celebrity crush is Theo James.
Pete Davidson.
Summer Walker.
Zendaya.
Ryan Reynolds.
Can I look at my list?
Michael B. Jordan.
Timothy Chalamet or Harry Styles.
Johnny Depp or...
Or Jeff Probst.
Michael B. Jordan.
Natalie Portman.
Dove Cameron.
Zendaya.
Madeline Pench.
Tom Holland.
Mine's Aubrey Plaza.
Tom Holland. I've always liked Tom Holland. And I also like Pete Davidson.
Florence Pugh.
A Raven from Teen Titans.
Young Ian Somerhalder.
Zendaya.
Back in the day, it was Kelly Preston, Alyssa Milano. The list goes on and on.
Our celebrity crush is Antoine.
Marie Antoinette. Who is your celebrity crush?
My celebrity crush is the one and only Madison Pettis.
John Krasinski and Blake Lively.
Mine's Tom Holland.
I also really like Tom Holland. He's just really cute. And younger Hugh Grant in Music and Lyrics is like top notch. I really like him.
My celebrity crush is Jordan Fisher.
Don't act like all...
Sorry, micromanager. Just...
Oh my gosh!
My celebrity crush is Doja Cat.
My wife.
My celebrity crush is Leah Garrett, but you can't tell her that I said that because it's a secret.
Justin Timberlake.
Heath Ledger, even though he's dead.
Hoping and praying Leah does not see this one.
Nah, don't worry, I'm sure she won't. It's not like she shot it and edited it and everything.
Yeah, that's true. But let's not dwell on it for too long. Let's hear a message about Art Club.
The nice thing about Art Club is that it's an open studio. Art Club is just a great space to get help and communicate with other people.
This is the best club to be at. Come to Art Club!
Lola, what are you drawing?
I draw a horsey.
That's so good. I drew a baby duck. His name is Bagel.
I love him. He's so quackalicious.
Consider this our formal audition for Art Club.
Art Club, accept us, please.
All right, enough of that. We should really do our part in saving these environment and compost these art pieces.
Hey there, Huskies. Just sending you out a quick message from your very own environmental club, straight to you and only you.
In the cafeterias, there should be one or two places to compost your food. It is important to only compost the things you know are compostable. Otherwise, the compost bin is contaminated.
You can compost any natural foods or products made from paper. No plastic or unnatural products. The compost bins can be found on either side of the North Cafeteria
or the South Cafeteria.
If you really can't find it, look for the bin labeled compost.
Please be careful with what you're putting in the bins. If you truly don't know if it's compostable, it's always better to throw it in the trash.
When in doubt, throw it out.
But on a serious note, do your part and take advantage of the compost bins in the lunchroom.
It's so easy. You don't even have to look away from March Madness.
So true, Sabine. Jimmy clearly hasn't been looking away from those games. Let's hear this week's update.
March Madness started off with a bang! The number one seeded Arizona Wildcats were pushed to their limits by the number nine seeded TCU Horned Frogs on Sunday night. The Wildcats prevailed 85-80 in overtime on the back of Ben Mathrin's 30 points, including a game-tying three at the end of regulation. The Michigan State Spartans took on former Spartan point guard Foster Lawyer and Davidson and prevailed 74-73 in an up-and-down, fast-paced game. The Gonzaga Bulldogs got a true test from the number 9-seeded Memphis Tigers. They trailed by 10 points at halftime when Drew Timmy told his team, "We're not about to go down as some soft guys." And soft guys they were not. The Gonzaga Bulldogs prevailed 80-76 and advanced to their fifth straight Sweet 16. Sweet 16 starts on Thursday and the Elite 8 starts on Saturday. So once again, let's get ready to rumble!
Hey, what are you still doing here?
Yeah, get out of here!
Go on spring break!
Scram! Go to Florida or wherever you're going.